गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द जीके क्लास। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट सम वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस एंड फैक्चुअल क्वेश्चंस। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, एज यू नो दैट इन आवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द प्रोसेस ऑफ डाइजेशन एंड हाउ इट टेक्स प्लेस इन आवर बॉडी, एंड we have also discussed about the components of blood and how oxygen is carried out by the blood in our body and we have discussed about the oxygenated and deoxygenated blood. Okay, so dear student, in our previous lecture we have discussed about the oxygenated and deoxygenated blood. So let's start our today's discussion. Starts with the difference between the process of breathing and respiration. Okay. Breathing and respiration. So dear students, many of you thinks that these both the terms are the same thing, but in actual the both process is different. Okay, as I told you that breathing is a part of respiration. Okay, so we should know the difference between the process of breathing and respiration. Okay, so breathing is simply the inhalation and exhalation. Okay, the inhalation of oxygen and exhalation of carbon dioxide is breathing. The inhalation of oxygen exhalation of CO2 means carbon dioxide, and the exhalation of CO2 is known as breathing. So this is the very basic definition. This is the very basic thing that simply we can say that the inhalation and exhalation, the process of inhalation, as you know that we inhale the oxygen and we exhale the carbon dioxide. But when it comes to the process of respiration, then that is different thing. Okay. I think in our previous lecture I have discussed a little bit about this. Okay, a little bit, but today I am going to explain in a very detailed way that how can you say that the respiration and breathing both are the different process. Okay, how can you say that? So dear students, when we have to say about the process of respiration, then process by which the process by which living things produce energy. From food. So when it comes to the respiration, then we can say that the process by which the living things produce energy from food. So in other words, we can say that this is a complete process. Okay, this includes the complete process when we inhale the oxygen, then oxygen carried out by our blood to the various body parts, and when there is the release of energy, and the process by which the living things produce energy from food, then how this process takes place? Let's discuss in detail. Okay, so the process. This is another point. The process by which cells use the process. By which oxygen to break up to break down sugar and obtain energy and the process by which cells use oxygen. As you know that with the oxygen which we inhale passes to our the various type of carried out by blood to the various cells, and when it reaches to the cells, when oxygen reaches to our cells, then there the process of oxidation takes place. Okay? The process by which cells use this oxygen. Okay? Who use oxygen? Cells use that oxygen. And how this oxygen reaches to that cells? How this oxygen reaches to that cells? Because this oxygen is carried out by your blood, and that blood is known as oxygenated blood, which I have discussed in our previous lecture. मैं आपको बताया था कि जो ब्लड के द्वारा जो ऑक्सीजन कैरी किया जाता है ब्लड के द्वारा, उस ब्लड को ऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड कहते हैं। तो जब हम सांस लेते हैं तो जो ऑक्सीजन हमारे लंग्स तक लंग्स के लंग्स से फिर दोबारा जब वहाँ से ब्लड के द्वारा पूरे बॉडी में जो ऑक्सीजन हर सेल्स के पास जो पहुँचाया जाता है, तो वहाँ पर जो ऑक्सीजेशन की प्रोसेस होती है, जैसा कि हम जानते हैं कि जो एनर्जी रिलीज होती है माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया में होती है। तो हमने बताया था कि उसको आपको डिटेल में हायर क्लास में पढ़ना है। यहाँ पर हम आपको बता रहे हैं बेसिक डिफरेंस की ब्रीथिंग और रिस्पिरेशन दोनों अलग चीज है। ब्रीथिंग सिंपली है इनहेलेशन और एक्सहेलेशन, और जो रिस्पिरेशन है वो क्या है, जब हम ऑक्सीजन लेते हैं तो हमारे हर सेल्स के पास हमको पहुँचता है ऑक्सीजन, जो कि ब्लड के द्वारा कैरी किया जाता है। तो वहाँ पर जो प्रोसेस होता है एनर्जी रिलीज जो होती है, तो इस टोटल प्रोसेस को रिस्पिरेशन कहते हैं। ऑक्सीजन ले लिए फिर वो हमारे जो सेल्स तक पहुंचा, फिर वहां पे ऑक्सीडेशन के प्रोसेस के बाद जो एनर्जी रिलीज हुई, इस होल प्रोसेस को रिस्पिरेशन कहते हैं। इस होल प्रोसेस को क्या कहते हैं? इस होल प्रोसेस को रिस्पिरेशन कहते हैं। एंड ब्रीथिंग इज समथिंग व्हिच इज सिंपली यू कैन से दैट द इनहेलेशन एंड एक्सहेलेशन, दैट इज सिंपली इनहेलेशन एंड एक्सहेलेशन, दैट इज। एंड व्हेन इट्स कम टू द रिस्पिरेशन देन I have written here the two points. This is the point number two, okay, for respiration. This is the point number one. The process by which living things produce energy from food. This is a very basic and simple definition. That the process by which living things produce energy from food. And how the energy is produced from the food? How this energy is produced from the food? That is explained in this point. Okay, I have explained that point here. The process by which cells use oxygen. The process by which cells. Okay, as you know that the structural and functional unit of life is cells. Cell is the smallest unit of our body. As I have discussed in our previous class that cells are the smallest unit of life, or we can say that the structural and functional unit of life is cells. Okay, so the process by which the cells use oxygen to break down sugar and obtain energy. Here, what happens? Here only the oxygen goes inside our body. Okay, that process is inhalation, and the release of carbon dioxide. That is the byproduct. That is the byproduct of the process of oxidation which takes place in our cells. So the only the inhalation and exhalation means that is the breathing. But when it comes to the respiration, then it involves a whole process by which the oxygen reaches to our body cells and body parts, and after that there is the release of energy. Okay, and that the whole process is known as respiration. That whole process is known as respiration. And breathing is simply the inhalation and exhalation, inhalation of oxygen and exhalation of carbon dioxide. Okay, so I think this is very clear. Now you are able to answer, and now you are able to differentiate between the process of breathing and respiration. Okay, so dear student, this is the as you know that in our every lecture first I discussed about the scientific term and some basic general questions in a very general way. That what is the, then after that we discuss some MCQ related to general knowledge. Okay, so let's move on to the next topic, that is the MCQ related to general knowledge questions. Okay, so let's start. I think this is very clear to you. So let's start the MCQ multiple choice questions are in a very simple way. So dear students, let's start. So our first question is about in which year the first Nobel Prize was awarded. In which year the first Nobel Prize was awarded. So the answer is 1901. Okay, 1901. This is a very important general knowledge question. That in which year the first Nobel Prize was awarded. Okay, so related to the same, The next question is about who created the Nobel Prize? Okay. Who created the Nobel Prize? Who created the Nobel Prize? So the answer is who created the Nobel Prize? So answer is Alfred Nobel. Alfred Nobel. Now moving to the next question. Who was the first Nobel Prize winner from India? Who was the first Nobel Prize winner from India? Rabindranath Tagore. So dear students, we should know about the Alfred Nobel. Let's discuss something about the Alfred Nobel, who created the Nobel Prize. Alfred Nobel. So let's discuss something about Alfred Nobel. Alfred. We are going to discuss about Alfred Nobel. Okay. And who was the first Nobel Prize winner? That is Rabindranath Tagore. So Alfred Nobel he was a Swedish chemist. He was a Swedish you are also a chemist, okay. He was also an engineer. Industrialist. Okay. He was also an industrialist. okay?
They must be known for the,
this is his identification, okay? This is an identification, and we can also say that
he was
famously known for invention of dynamo. Okay, dear students. So this is some additional information about the Alfred Nobel. He was a Swedish chemist. Also, he was an engineer, industrialist, and he was famously known for the invention of dynamite. He invented the dynamite. Okay. So, what is the identification? What is the identity of Alfred Nobel? He was a Swedish chemist, engineer, and industrialist, and he was famously known for invention of dynamite. Okay. So, dear students, today we discussed a lot of things. We have discussed about the scientific process, breathing and respiration, and after that we just discuss some important questions. So, as you know that today we discuss the very important question. So, in our next lecture, we will discuss in detail about one more scientific terms, and after that, we will discuss some MCQ related to general knowledge questions. Okay, that's all for today. Have a nice day.